offer, so do not wait. Give Skillshare a try today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do not forget to like and subscribe. And please let me know if you have any other good nominees for...
Hey guys.
Hello everyone, my name is JJ, and I thought today we would talk about some of the more obscure flags of Canada. I already did a video about all of the provincial flags of Canada, so I thought we would do something a little bit different today. We are going to look at some flags that are not associated with specific places in Canada, but are rather sort of symbolic representations of, you know, groups of people, or history, or ideas. But just a heads up before I begin, today's video is sponsored by our friendly friends at Skillshare, the awesome teach you how to do anything website. They have a great deal right now where you can get 2 free months if you sign up using the link in the thing below. We will talk more about Skillshare in a bit. So let us begin with some of the popular variations on Canada's beloved maple leaf flag. Because the Canadian maple leaf flag is so iconic, it is very popular to make modified versions of it for different groups. For example, a lot of LGBT groups in Canada use a maple leaf flag with rainbow bars instead of the red ones. There have also been a lot of efforts to create an Aboriginal looking maple leaf flag for Native Canadians. You sometimes see ones with a sort of Indian chief. Type figure on the maple leaf, like this one or this one. Then there is some variation on this, where you kind of have the whole maple leaf flag run through a kind of indigenous pattern. You see this version of the maple leaf once in a while too. This was designed by a guy in the 1990s who thought we needed a new version of the maple leaf to specifically acknowledge the French Canadians, which is what these blue bars are supposed to represent. This is sometimes rather presumptuously called the Canadian Unity Flag. Then of course you have the Canadian pothead community, who are very fond of doing was exactly because it was very bland and generic and inoffensive. Canada this flag is actually quite unusual among them. Symbolism. Nothing on the flag represents anything in particular. It is just a flag that represents Canada and all Canadians. So when some group comes along and makes some little modification to the Maple Leaf flag, you know, adding some little feature to make it more representative of gays or French Canadians or whatever, they're really betraying the purpose of the Canadian flag, which was to be a symbol of unity for all Canadians. Speaking of Canadian history, here's a flag from Canada's past known as the Pearson Pendant. See, in the old days, Canada's flag looked like this, or at least something like this. The precise design changed a lot, which is one of the reasons why it was not very popular. In the 20th century, various Canadian governments made various half-hearted attempts to create a new Canadian flag, but none of these really went anywhere. So in 1964, the new Prime Minister of Canada, Lester Pearson, got frustrated with all of this, and he was like, fine, I'll just invent a new Canadian flag on my own. And then one day he got up and he was just like, okay, check this out. I've come up with this, and this should be the new flag of Canada. It's got three maple leaves in the middle, because the maple leaf is the symbol of Canada, and then we've got these two blue bars on either side, because Canada borders two oceans. This was not popular. Even though a lot of Canadians wanted a new flag, there was not a lot of support for the idea that the Prime Minister should just unilaterally come up with one on his own. And That's why this thing quickly got the dismissive nickname of the Pearson Pendant. And Pearson eventually backed down in his